Welcome to my review of the Carrizoando Hunter, a traditional fixed blade made in a small factory in the northernmost church village of Sweden. The name of the village is the same as the name of the knife brand, Carrizoando. The village is located in northern Lapland, 250 kilometers north of the Arctic Circle, a part of the world that is known for northern lights and amazing landscapes. The cutlery company Carrizoando manufactures a whole range of traditional fixed blades. The knives are all made in the Nordic style. They've recently also started to make folding knives, which I will be reviewing in another video. I just mentioned it, but it's important to note again that unlike other Swedish knife brands, the Carrizoando knives are actually made in Sweden. Carrizoando uses traditional materials for all their knife handles, curly birch, also known as mesa birch, and reindeer antler. As for the blade steel, you can choose from simple carbon steel over 12C27 stainless steel to even more sophisticated steels such as RWL34 powder steel or Damascus steel. I consider the Hunter as one of Carrizoando's flagship knife models. As for the specs, the total length is 21 centimeters. The blade length is 10 centimeters. And the blade thickness is 3 millimeters. The weight comes in at 102 grams. Since the knives are handcrafted, the specs may vary a little bit from knife to knife. No one is exactly like another. Let's do a quick size comparison. Here I've got a Mora Companion. This is an Enzo Trapper. And here I've got the well-known SE3. Please note that the Carrizoando Hunter, like virtually all traditional Nordic knives, is not a full tang construction. Instead, the tang is hidden. It is glued into the hilt. Just for comparison purposes, here I've got a Puco knife by Haimo Roselli. It's basically the same design principle. However, the Carrizoando Hunter comes with an additional brass finger guard. Can you baton with this knife? I guess some light batoning shouldn't be a problem. Since I'm not interested in destructive knife testing, I will use the knife for what it was made for. As I already mentioned, the handle is made of oiled curly birch and reindeer stag. The handle is nicely 3D contoured. And it provides a comfortable four-finger grip. The blade is made of RWL34, a premium stainless powder metallurgy steel by the Swedish company Damasteel. A really high quality steel that is hardened to 61 HRC. The blade shape is a classic draw point design with a pronounced belly. The blade finish is almost mirror polished. However, the most important feature is the zero edge Scandi grind, which is ideal for woodwork. The Scandi grind simply excels at biting into wood. But of course, you can also use the knife for food prep. Thank you. Finally, let's take a look at the sheath, which, by the way, is also made in the Carisoando factory. It's a traditional cowhide leather sheath with a belt loop. It's a rather thick material. The sheath holds the knife firmly in place. The sheath also features a plastic insert that protects both the blade edge and the sheath. Carisoando wants knife making to be perceived as a traditional craft. Of course, they use machines, but there is still a fair amount of skilled handwork that goes into making these knives. And Carisoando wants to be perceived as a truly Swedish company, or to be even more specific, they want to be perceived as a knife brand from northern Lapland, hence the choice of handle materials. So if you're interested in traditional Nordic knives, you should definitely check out the Carisoando website and catalog. They have a fairly widespread distribution network, so the knives are not that difficult to find. I hope you enjoyed my review. A special thank you goes to Per-Erik Niva, who provided me with the photos and video footage from the Carisoando factory. Thanks for watching and take care.